मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एमएस एक्सेस फॉर्म्स एंड यू नो हाउ टू क्रिएट फॉर्म्स फॉर योर टेबल्स इन एमएस एक्सेस। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू क्रिएट रिपोर्ट्स फॉर योर टेबल। वंस यू हैव कंप्लीटेड टेबल्स इन एमएस एक्सेस, यू वॉन्ट टू टेक प्रिंट आउट और यू वॉन्ट टू अनालाइज योर डेटास और यू वॉन्ट टू रिप्रेजेंट योर डेटा इन hard copy, you can take printouts using MS Access reports option. You can change or modify, you can modify the reports and you can take printouts. So I'll teach you how to create reports for your tables in MS Access. Before I'm going to start this session, I want to give a recap for previous class. Previous class we were discussed about forms. So once you have completed tables in your MS Access application, we can represent your tables in a forms way. Form is a screen, it is a front end screen. It will display your table data with the designed view. Okay, so the form, what is form here? The form wizard can assist you in constructing basic form layouts. It has some designs. You can present your tables in some designed manner. Instead of constructing a form manually, you can use this form wizard to quickly produce a basic form layout. Using form wizard, we can create a forms. So last class we discussed design a form. So what is the design a form? How to design? Using form design view, we can create a design a form. So we can set a field list dialog box, properties sheet, you can set properties, so toolbox, we can set these properties, we can design a form. Design a form, once you have to complete the table and go to insert forms, just click a few windows, your form will be ready. Okay, and we discussed about queries. Queries means what is the programming statements. You want to retrieve your data from your tables, you can use queries wizard. You can take some particular data, particular report from your tables. You want to analyze the data or you want to retrieve some columns of fields only from your table, you can use queries. You can retrieve data. So we discussed what is queries in MS Access. And this class we are going to discuss about reports. What is report? A report is a design document that displays formatted data from one or more database tables. Reports are designed for printing and distribution to an audience. Yes, it is the final stage of your presentation of a table. Once you have completed your table or data work in your MS Access application, you want to take present to your boss or you want to take a hard copy, you can go for reports option. Reports are used to summarize large quantities of data into meaningful information using calculations, record list, totals and other reports objects. So you want to do some analyze analytical data or you want to present some other way in your tables, you can go for reports. Reports produce paper forms such as invoices and inventory lists. You are doing a business, you want to take your stock list of data items from your table or you want to prepare inventory report, stock items of your company, you can go for reports. Access provides several report wizards. Using report wizard option, you can set for report for your table. I will teach you and I will explain how to create report in using report wizards. Access permits you to view and modify results of report. Once you have created reports in MS Access, you can change your report or modify your report as you want. Okay, reports have a design view and a run view. Reports are designed under the assumption that the data and the formatting will be printed. Access supports a print view that allows you to insert the report before your printing. Before you are going to take a printouts of reports, you can make changes in report sheet. Okay, reports can be based on either database table or result of query. It can be finalized your database table or result of query. Okay, so I will teach you now how to create reports in MS Access. Yes, now I'm going to show you how to create a report in MS Access. You have to open MS Access application in your PC. So go to start button. Go to start button. Search applications list MS Office. Yes, MS Office. Under MS Office, you have to choose MS Access 2010. So this is the front window opening in MS Access application. Already I have created one table in MS Access. I want to open the table. So recent, or you can create, you can go for create. Contents table 1. Yes, open. This is the table I have created already. I have a field name in the table, name, class, and subject marks Tamil, English, Max, Science, Social. I have entered 3 rows of data in my table. I want to again open it in design view. So already we know how to design a table. So you have to enter the field name here, name, class, and your table fields, and you can set its corresponding data types. So here class, it will it will get only text type of data. Name, we are going to enter alphabets of data, and Tamil, English, we are going to collect here marks. So I have entered its data type as number. Okay, so this is the design view, and the field properties, you can set its lookup and the general field properties view in this window. Here I'm going to open my table. You want to add some more data in your table, you can add here. So I want to add one more record. Class is 8th standard. I'm going to enter marks of Rahul, 89 45 and 56 67 90. Okay, so these are the data I have entered in my table. Now I'm going to show you how to create a report for this table. Okay, so close this. Already I have created a report. I want to delete these reports, cuts and cut. So I have opened my table. I want to open my table, and you have to go this main tab. You can see file, home, create, external data, database, tools, fields. So click on create tab. Here you can see a report and a report wizard. Using a report wizard and using a report, we can create a reports for your table. Already we discussed what is report. Report is a format of a printable. You can take a printout of your table of data. So here I'm going to create report wizard. Once you click the report wizard, this window will be opened. Here you can see the your name of the table. Here you can see which fields do you want and your report. In your report, what are the fields you want to present? Here you have to set that dead fields, list of fields you want to present in your reports. I want to present all my fields in my table. So choose, just select this, click this icon. It will be selected and move to this side. Next, you have to click next. Here, do you want to add any grouping levels? Yes. Do you want to add? Yes, I want to add all my fields for grouping levels. Priority, you can set priority. Which one is the first one, which one is next one, you can set it here. Okay, so name, just click next. You can sort records by up to 4 fields in either ascending or descending order. Here you want to present your data as ascending order. In the field of any 4 fields, you can set it. Now I don't want to, so just click next. So here layout, which layout you want, portrait format or landscape format, and which layout, block or outline. You can see the model here, stepped. So I want to choose outline and portrait. Just click next. Preview report, you want to preview report or modify the report design. Again, you want to modify your report design or preview report. Just click finish. You can see here, this is the report for your table. Here you can see name, ID and the name of the student, their marks. In the I have choose Outlook formats, so it will present your data as Outlook formats. Here you can see. So once you got your report, you can convert this report sheet as any formats, PDF or XPS. Just click, I want to change this format as a PDF. Just click it, PDF. You can have to choose a location to save your PDF file. I selected desktop, and table name is a table, publish. Yes, your PDF report will be ready. Just click, go to desktop menu and click this PDF. You can see PDF format of your reports. So opening. So here, this is the PDF format for your reports. You can send through this email to your boss, or you can take a printouts, or you can send to someone. Okay. So again, I'm going to MS Access. So this is the way how to create report. Excel, you want to present this report as Excel, you can convert this, and you have to choose location, in which location you want to store your data. Here the file name and the file formats and browse, you can change location also. Click browse, you can change its location. So I don't want to change, it will be stored documents table 1.excel this path. So I want to change the desktop, desktop Excel as format, save. Click OK. Yes, now you can go to desktop menu. Your Excel as report stored in desktop menu. Click that Excel. You can see your table data, report data in Excel formats. This is the Excel formats. Okay, so we have these features in MS Access. Convert any other formats, export options. So more, you can convert as a Word or HTML document, you can choose it. Here you can see it, it's a view, one page view or two page view. You can set it here, you can change it. And the page setup, you want to take a printout of your reports, you can set some page setup, top margin, and it's a margin setups you can set, and I click OK, it will be ready to print. Margins also you can set it. So this is the way we have to create a report in MS Access. This is the view for your report. Here you can add or delete some items in your reports. This is the view. You can I want to add some logo, you can add it logo, choose the picture, it will become to reports. And the title, you want to give some title for report, we can give it. So these options, date and time, you want to present date and time, click OK, it will be so, date and time and reports. Page numbers, you want to give page numbers, just click OK. Page numbers will come to your reports header and footer. Okay, so these are the features we have in MS Access. So this is the way you have to create report for your table. Already we discussed forms. Just go to create and click form. You can see your table of table data in the form formats. Just use this menu, previous and next, previous, next. You can see all the data in your table. Okay, so you can set its design formats. We have more formats. You want to insert image, you can insert image in your form. Okay, just close it. This is the form we can create in MS Access. So we discussed now what is a report, how to create a report using report wizard, how to create reports, and using reports you can create a report also. This is the way. Just you can set a form, themes also, more themes available, and you can set your favorite theme as you want. You can set it here. And page setup, this is the portrait page format. Here you can see other report view, printable views you can see here. Page setup, go to page setup, you can change its page format and size legal. As per your data, you can set your page setup. Okay, so this is the way you have to create reports using report wizard. So, and other options already we discussed. Okay, so I want to wind up this session. What we discussed today, forms and reports in MS Access. It is the format to take a printout for your table of data. So far we discussed both reports in MS Access. So we have completed forms and reports concepts in MS Access. So I hope you understood what is report and how to create a report using report wizard and reports option in a create tab in MS Access. Okay, so I want to wind up this session. We discussed about reports and the forms. What is report? A report is a option you can present your table data in a printable formats. This is called report. So we discussed how to create report in MS Access applications. Okay, so go through this video from beginning to end and complete your classwork and bookmark exercises and write all the answers in book bag exercises. Complete the fill ups and one word answers and question answers in your classwork notes. So I send the answer key for your WhatsApp group, kindly check it. And you have to complete your classwork task and hand over your classwork notes to school. So watch this video. If you have any doubts in the concept of MS Access reports and forms, send your queries to my mail ID or WhatsApp number. I will help to solve your doubts. Okay, so I will meet you all in my next video with the next chapter.